Hey, it's me, Destin. This is the second channel, Smarter Every Day 2. In the most recent video I uploaded, I struck a match with a bullet with my buddy John Henry. We did that a long time ago. It was really fun. We wanted to do it again with slow motion video, and we saw some really neat things happen. In fact, I kept a list while editing of things I wanted to talk about that I thought were really neat phenomena, like physical things that happened during this that I didn't include in the first video that I thought would be really fun to talk about. So let's just go through my list here. The first thing that happened at about 8.5 minutes in the main channel video, we had this really interesting thing happen. When I was editing the video, I just happened to be plugging along, and then I paused because I was working on audio or whatever it is I was working on, and I found this frame. Now, it is a single frame in the video. If I play it real time, the event looks like this.
3, 2, 1, fire.
All right.
But if you pause it, there's just one frame that looks like that. And I instantly recognize that as rolling shutter, which I love. Rolling shutter and aliasing, they're fascinating to me. In fact, I did a whole episode on this. If you want to check that out, it's episode 172 on the main channel. It's amazing, like glorious, glorious footage on that episode. It's really fun if you want to check it out. Anyway, when I saw this, I was like, oh man, there's rolling shutter. Now, what that means is those two matches that you see look like a wave, they are the ones that got hit. And so you, sure enough, you go back and you look at the slow motion video, check out what you see. Isn't that interesting? So that means that the bullet came along and it plucked two of those matches like a guitar string. And when it did that, they vibrated. And I don't know, I don't have a mental image of it in my head right now, but you would think because it's plucked from the top and it's fixed at the bottom, there's a boundary condition there, you would think that means that the amplitude of the sine wave or whatever it is would be larger at the top of the match than it is at the bottom of the match because you have a boundary condition there. Just for fun, here's the guitar string footage from that rolling shutter video, and you can see it's going back and forth, back and forth. Now imagine one side of the guitar strings would be pinned in a certain location, so instead of having this sine wave looking thing, you would have more of a tapered version, and if you go back and you look at what actually happened with this match, you see that, and that's incredible. I thought that was cool. I didn't want to put it in the main channel video because I just wanted to keep that tight, but on Smarter Every Day 2, we talk about whatever we want, so I thought that was really neat, and I thought you would find that exciting as well. All right, so let's see what else we have. Oh, here's another one. At around 12 minutes in the main channel video, the bullet's coming along. I guess it would be right to left in the screen here. Think about the momentum of that system. You have a stationary match and you have a moving bullet, so all the momentum is moving in that direction, right? But as soon as the bullet touches the very tip of the match there, something amazing happens. There's this explosion, or maybe it's in the fracture event, I don't know what it is. Long story short, gases go opposite the direction of the bullet. Watch this in slow motion. So that's one of two things. Number one, either it's a chemical explosion that's happening when you have the bullet coming in contact with the phosphorus up there and it just blows that out, or what you have to have is compression of a solid and then the release of that strain energy in the fracture. So one of those two things is happening, and I'm leaning toward explosion, but I think it's amazing. Another thing that's cool is after you see that puff of cloud going back towards the gun, you can see the blast wave of all the gases come back from the rifle, blow it back. So you see it's like bullet, gases, and you can just understand everything that happens in the system, and it's beautiful. And I thought you'd really like to see that because I thought it was really, really fun. Okay, gunpowder. If you look at some of them, especially the ones where I put a white background in the background, when Henry and I were shoot, we would talk about, oh man, look at all the gunpowder. It's such a dirty burn. What's happening there? Now, I think that has something to do with the type of rifle we're using and the type of ammunition we're using. So if, here, let me just zoom in here. I've got to focus my camera. If I focus right here, okay, so the rifle that we're using is a .22 long rifle. It's a Ruger 10/22, like everybody in the world has one of those, it seems like. But the ammunition we're firing is short rifle ammunition. Now, if you just look at it, you can see pretty easily, let's go way in here. If you can, let me focus. Yeah, if you just look at it, you can see that the brass on the long rifle is a lot bigger than the brass on the short rifle. Now, what that means is when you, focusing the camera here, when you seat the cartridge, the brass cartridge, in that rifle barrel, excuse me, something interesting is happening. So as that thing goes in there, you have a place where the rifling of the barrel starts, right? Now, if you have the correct size cartridge, the brass will go all the way up to the rifling and the bullet will be seating, like up inside the rifling. It'll be started almost. But if you shoot a short bullet, what's gonna happen is there's gonna be a gap. There's gonna be a gap between the bullet and the rifling. Now, what I think is happening, and I explained this better in the bullet versus bullet episode. I 3D printed these things and showed how the powder like sits up in there and all that kind of stuff. I think that the gunpowder is jumping the gap. I don't know that that's true, but it just seems to me like all that gunpowder in a 22 short rifle bullet would have plenty of time to burn in the barrel. So I think it's going out around the whole thing. So I think the gunpowder is sneaking around the bullet, it's going down the barrel, and it's getting pushed by gases. That's why I think we see this cloud of stuff. And in fact, check this out. This is that smoke stripper thing that I made. Henry and I put in place. We put this there to strip all the gases out. Look how dirty that is. And if you look really, really close, you can see there's actually pitting around the perimeter of that. And I think that's just straight up gunpowder, like hitting that thing and damaging it. So I think that's really interesting. Now, all this is important because I think it played in to the really crazy thing that happened. At the end of the video, John Henry and I decided we wanted to take a match and we wanted to break it like this, and we wanted to shove it into the rifle, and we wanted to put a bullet behind it. And once we did that, the idea was to fire that thing down the rifle and maybe even strike a match with a match. We had no idea, we just wanted to try it. But a crazy thing happened, and if you saw the main channel video, it actually worked, but we struck the match with a bullet. It's crazy, check this out. And this is the reaction that we had that I wanted to put in the main channel video, but decided against it. You know, sometimes when you're in the garage with your friend John Henry, and you decide to try something really, really dumb, we just did that. So,
and it worked.
So, there's a match down there. We put a match in the gun. And we put a bullet behind the match. Allow me to show you a bullet carrying a match striking a match. What do you have to say for yourself, John Henry?
My mind is completely blown at this point. I just
yep, and she lights off. So there you go. That's a thing that can happen. John Henry thinks this is the only time in history this has ever happened. Can you?
I would like for somebody to prove me wrong.
There you go. You're getting smarter every day. Hope you enjoyed that. Wow. Okay. It's time to go to bed. Okay, so here's the theory. Now, we were talking about the gases jumping around that bullet. I would think that if you had a match in the barrel and you had a bullet pushing that thing, if the shock would shatter the match. That's what I would assume. I don't know that that's true or not. This is a subsonic thing, but I would assume that it would at least break the wood of the match. That's not what we saw. We saw the bullet, which is a hollow point bullet, by the way. We saw the wood of the match being held inside that hollow point hole right there. And it was splintered just a little bit, but the bullet was actually spinning as it was flying, but the match wasn't spinning. So I have a theory. Now, it's just a theory. I can't focus again. It's just a theory. I think that the gases that came around the bullet started pushing the wooden match that's very lightweight, just started pushing it down the barrel, and then the bullet then caught up with the match. So the relative velocity between the match and the bullet, I think they were pretty low, so it didn't shatter the match. And then that thing was just there, and it was already moving in that direction, and it just kind of held it all the way. I think it's hilarious. It's just a hilarious video, and it's just like unbelievable, and it's so dopey. You're like, how on earth is this a thing that happened? But it happened, and we caught it on slow-mo, and that's awesome. When I told Henry about that theory, John Henry said, look, man, you can science words this all you want, but it happened, and I don't think it would happen again if we tried it 100 times. And I think he's right. So anyway, it was really cool that it happened on the only shot that we did, but I thought it was really fun. So that's it for my little note list here. I kind of did them out of order. But did you see anything interesting on that video that you think is worthy of talking about? Any phenomenon that you thought were pretty cool? I enjoyed it. My goal was to get a really pretty shot. I'm glad that we did. It's just something I've always wanted to do. I hope you enjoyed that video. I hope you enjoyed the second channel. I just like to just kind of talk about stuff here and just react to whatever's going on. I don't know. It's a simple channel. I don't take it too seriously. Big thanks to everybody that has subscribed to it. There's a lot of people that follow the second channel, and I think that's really cool. But ultimately, it's just a place to have fun. Also, I want to thank everybody that supports Smarter Every Day in any way that you do that. If you're a patron of Smarter Every Day, I probably already sent you a baseball, a Smarter Every Day baseball. You can do that at patreon.com/smarterevery day. But a really cool thing that I'm doing recently that it seems to be working well is I have an email list. There's about, I don't know, it's like 60 or 70,000 people that when I upload a video, I just shoot them an email and say, hey, new video. And that's cool because there's no algorithm in between me and you. You can just say, oh, it's a new Smarter Every Day video. I can go check that out. You don't have to worry about, you know, YouTube serving it to you or anything like that. It's just there. So if you want to check that out, I won't spam you. You can check that out at smartereveryday.com. Go to the email list and join the people that are getting that email. Anyway, that's it. I hope you enjoyed the second channel. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Destin. You're getting smarter every day. Have a good one.